Hello friends, in this session we are going to take up questions 16 to 20 of class 8 Aryabhatta paper 2020 section B. So looking at this question, the number of diagonals of a regular polygon is 27. Each of the interior angle of the polygon is of measure. So now we know that number of diagonals of n-sided polygon are given by the formula n into n minus 3 by 2. For this you can refer the video on polygons which explains how do we come to this formula. So now it is given to us that the regular polygon is there and the number of diagonals is 27. So we can find out how much sided the polygon is. We can say n into n minus 3 by 2 is equal to 27, which implies n into n minus 3 is equal to 54. So now we can write this as 9 into 6. 54 can be written as 9 into 6 because we have to write it in a format which is n into n minus 3. So 6 is obviously 9 minus 3. So we can say n is equal to 9. So we have this 9-sided polygon. Now in the same video on polygons, it is explained what is the interior angle of a regular polygon, and that is given by the formula n minus 2 into 180 by n. So now if we have to find out the interior angle, right? So we put n equal to 9 in this formula and find out what is the value. So we get 9 minus 2 into 180 by 9. So this cancels, we get 20, and this is 7 into 20, which is 140 degree. So this is the answer to this question. The interior angle of the polygon is of the measure 140 degree, which is option A. Moving to the next question, in triangle ABD, AC is the median as well as the altitude to BD. Now BD is extended to a point E. In triangle ACE, AD is the median to CE, which of the following is true? So obviously we'll first have to draw the figure according to what they're saying. So first of all, let's draw this triangle ABD. Let's call this A, this B and D. And we are saying, it's given that AC is the median. Sorry, this is point D. ABD is the triangle. AC is the median as well as the altitude to BD. So this means this angle is 90 degree. These two angles are 90 degree and BC is equal to CD. So now we know from the properties of triangle that if AC is median as well as altitude, the triangle has to be either isosceles triangle or equilateral triangle. So this implies that AB should be equal to AD. Right? So this means this is equal to this. AB is equal to AD. Now BD is extended to a point E, and in triangle ACE, AD is the median to CE. So that means it is extended in this direction, and we get this AE, such that in the triangle ACE, AD becomes the median of CE. So this means since AD is median to CE, this implies CD is equal to DE, right? Now if we look at this triangle ADE, we know that for a triangle, any one side is always greater than the sum of other two. That is the basic property of a triangle, right? So this means AE has to be greater than ए सी प्लस सॉरी ए डी प्लस डी ई राइट एंड सिंस ए डी इज नथिंग बट ए बी फ्रॉम दिस वन सो वी कैन से दैट ए ई इज ग्रेटर देन ए बी प्लस डी ई विच इज ऑप्शन सी सो दिस इज द आंसर टू दिस क्वेश्चन ऑप्शन सी इज द आंसर ए ई इज ग्रेटर देन ए बी प्लस डी ई मूविंग टू द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इफ द सेलिंग प्राइस इज डबल्ड The profit triples, then the profit percentage is. So let the profit, the original profit be P. So we can say that the selling price is equal to, we know that selling price is equal to the cost price plus the profit. Now if we are saying the selling price is doubled, so this becomes SP new is 2 times of SP, the profit triples, so this becomes P new is 3P. Now again we know that selling price new will be again equal to the cost price plus the new profit. Sorry, this is equal to. So this becomes, we can write SP new as 2 times of SP is equal to CP plus we can write P new as 3P. Now 2SP, we can replace SP from 1. And we can say 2 times of CP plus P is equal to CP plus 3P. This gives us P is equal to CP. Right? So now the percent profit is nothing but P by CP into 100. So this is equal to 100%. So option B is the answer to this question. Moving to the next question, in the given figure, AC is the diameter of the circle and angle ADB is equal to 20 degree. So this angle is given to be 20 degree. Right, then we have to find out angle BPC. So let's first join A and P. Right, angle BPC is what we have to find out. This we can say is sum of angle APB and angle APC. Right, we've just divided the bigger angle into two parts and we are just saying that angle BPC is the sum of these two angles. Now angle APC is equal to 90 degree. Why? Because angle in a semicircle, AC is the diameter, it is given, right? So, this angle APC will be 90 degree. So, now we have to find out angle APB to be able to find out angle BPC. Now, angle APB will be equal to angle ADB. Why? This is because the angles subtended by an arc in the same segment are equal. For this, you can, this is a theorem of a circle. You can look at the video theorems based on arc to see the details of this, how do we arrive at this theorem. So according to that theorem, these two angles are equal. So this means angle APB is equal to 20 degree because angle ADB is given to be 20 degree. So this implies angle BPC is equal to 20 plus 90, which is 110 degree, which is option D. So option D is the answer to this question. Now moving to the last question of this session, if A by B is equal to B by C is equal to C by D, then we have to find out the value of BQ plus CQ plus DQ by AQ plus BQ plus c cube. So we start with what is given to us. We say that a by b is equal to b by c is equal to c by d, and let's take that is equal to, let's say this is equal to k. Right, now looking at what we have to find out, it is b cube plus c cube plus d cube by a cube plus b cube plus c cube, which means that let's now these are whatever is in the denominator here is showing up in the numerator. So let's just take the reciprocal, and we can say b by a is equal to c by b is equal to d by c is equal to 1 by k. So we've just taken the reciprocal and nothing else. And now we take cube of all these. So we get b cube by a cube is equal to c cube by b cube is equal to d cube by c cube, and that is equal to nothing but 1 by k cube. Right? Now we take these two. And we use the properties of proportions, ratio proportion. For this you can refer to the video which named some useful properties of ratio and proportion, which talks about this property. So here, using those properties of ratio and proportion, we can say that before using the proportion, we are saying b cube by a cube is equal to c cube by b cube, and we can also write it as b cube by c cube equal to a cube by b cube. Now we'll use that property, and this, using that property of proportion, we get b cube plus c cube by c cube is equal to a cube plus b cube by b cube. Let's call this number 1. And here we just change the way it is written to b cube plus c cube by a cube plus b cube, and this is equal to c cube by b cube. We've just taken this here and we've taken this here, that's it, nothing else. And this we know is nothing but, from here we know that this is nothing but d cube by c cube, right? So similarly, using the same property, once again we get b cube plus c cube plus d cube by a cube plus b cube plus c cube is equal to c cube by b cube. And we can say this is equal, this, these are all equal to 1 by k cube. Right? Now, the first thing to note here is that we are solving the question, but looking at just the options, we know that the option A is A by B, which is nothing but K. The second option is B by C, which is again K. Third option is C by D, which is again K. And fourth option is D by A, which is not K, which is something else. So if the answer to this question were to be A, then it would have been all three, A, B and C. It could not be either A, B or C. Right? So now, since we have to answer only one option, we should look for D. And obviously, we should be able to figure it out whether it is coming out to be D or not. Right? So, this is clearly 1 by k cube, which is not option A, B and C. That we have seen from this calculation. Now, let's see what is D by A. We start from this here. Let's call this capital A. We start from here and we say A by B is equal to B by C is equal to C by D is equal to K. So what is D? D can be written as C by K. And if we replace C by B by K, it becomes B by K square. Or this is also equal to A by K cube. So this implies D by A is nothing but 1 by K cube. And this is what we are getting the value of this given expression. So this means this given expression is equal to D by A, which is option D. This is the answer to this question. So friends, if you like the video, please like it and share it with your friends and subscribe to our YouTube channel to get updates on the new sessions.